Okay, my dear students, now we are going to start our new session, geography. Last session we were discussing of migration, lesson number 3, and in that lesson we discussed type of migrations. And in type of migrations we discussed two type of migrations. One is a international migration and another one is a internal migration. Internal migration means what is it? Inside the country itself, if one person is crossing one state to another state, if he is going for searching better opportunity, it may be money, business, job, or anything else. That is known as international migration. Internal migration. Now we can see international migration. What do you mean by international migrations? If one person is crossing the border of that country and going to another country, or going to another continent to do any work, or in search of better opportunity, or in search of a standard of life, or a better education, anything else, that is known as international migrations. Now we can see another one. What is that? Next topic, it was causes of migration. That causes can be two. One is a push factor, another is a pull factor. Push factor as well as pull factor. Now again, next topic we discussed brief history of migration. I mean from ancient time to present time we discussed, in a short way, in a brief way we discussed it. And now after that we have discussed impact of migrations of two, I mean of donor regions as well as receiver regions. But we discussed only of donor region. What do you mean by donors? Donors means giving persons. The country which give people to another, that is known as a donor. Okay, the country which receives the people, that is known as a receiver. And in that thing we discussed impact of migration on donor regions. It have two type. One is a positive effect and another one is a negative effect. Both we discussed. Now we are going to discuss impact of migration on receiver regions. Okay, so dear students, take out the page number 25th. Okay, first point, positive effect. First point, immigration reduces underpopulation. Okay, when people come to in that particular country, then what will happen? Population number will increase. And next one we can see, so what is the next effect? Second point, it increases the supply of labor. Sometimes we know in developed countries, I mean receiver regions, they have what type of people? That is aged people, not working condition people, or only supportive peoples we can find there. Most of the people are supportive ones. So what they will do? They are unable to do the work. They are unable to fulfill the need of nations. But that will be fulfilled by these migrants. So the nation will get the number of laborers. Often it increases the supply of skilled labor. That is very important one. Whenever, if we are going to another country, they will prefer to only the people, those who have skilled ones. I mean engineers, doctors, and some other skilled peoples in other field, civil engineer, and like that, mechanics, driver, and such kinds of people. So they will get enough and sufficient number for their need. All this help in economic development. All of these labors will work for that particular receiver regions development. And now third point, immigrant workers may be willing to work at a cheaper rate than native workers. The people, those who are going to other state or other country, then what will happen? They are ready to do any type of work. Only they need money. That money also they will take less money. Okay, so the provider of job, he is satisfied, well satisfied, because he no need of giving more money. He is getting more labor with a cheap money. So, but native workers, what native workers, they will demand for more money. So, the industries or job providers, they are not preferring for native workers. They will prefer for migrant workers. They may also be willing to do the jobs that native workers avoid. Then the local workers, I mean native workers, they will not do some particular type of work, like cleaning the waste and or we can say so drainage, and these all the things they will avoid, or some particular jobs like any, they will consider that job is something like low class people are doing, or that some inferior complex may be there. That will migrant workers, migrant laborers, they will not show such kinds of selective jobs. They will do as they can do. Whatever they can do it, they will do. So let us go to next point. So immigration increases the working population. Immigration, what we can say, so immigration. Immigration increases the working population. That already we said, especially in developed regions, what will be where birth as well as death rates are low, and large section of the population comprises old people. That is what we discussed in early points. They have a large number of supportive people. And they are not a working community. They are old people, and so what, they are not able to do work. This situation can be overcome by accepting the outsiders to that particular country. And next one, the presence of people of different races, religion, language, culture in a society increases the understanding and tolerance among different groups. That is what a very important one. Whenever we are migrating to another country or to another state, then what will happen? We have to adjust with that people, isn't it? And we have to adjust with their culture and their custom and what we are, and their way of life and such and so on. Then what will happen? After some time, the people, those who are living in that particular area or particular country, they also will accept our culture or our way of life, and like adjustment will come, and then what will be the understanding and tolerance among different groups of people. Okay, and now let us see, people coming from other countries can encourage the local people to learn different languages. When the people coming from another country, they will be encouraged to learn another country's language. And same way, the people, those who are living there, they have to also learn the other country's language. Because when we know the language of other people, then we can do conversation easily. Otherwise, both people will suffer. Okay. So we can understand what is it? It will increase the understanding and tolerance among different group of people, and they will try to learn different languages, which makes it easier for them to work in other countries. So dear students, we will meet in next session. So have a nice day. Thank you. Take care.